A renegade Chicago priest is returning to his parish after temporary suspension during an investigation into sex abuse claims. The Archdiocesan Review Board found allegations by two brothers against Father Michael Flager were not credible. Church Militant's William Mahoney looks at what Flager and some baffled Chicago clergy are saying.
By these two brothers from Texas, and I am being restored as the senior pastor of St. Sabine Church.
Father Michael Flager will resume his social justice activism the first weekend of June as pastor of St. Sabina in Southside Chicago. This after the Windy City's Cardinal Blaise Supich announced his reinstatement in a letter published Monday. I ask you to welcome back Father Flager, thereby helping him take up again the ministry that has distinguished St. Sabina and the Archdiocese and beyond. Flager appeared Monday evening on the steps in front of St. Sabina, doubling down on the ministry that has distinguished the parish.
I'm going to become more aggressive against guns.
Yes.
And we are going to continue to fight every injustice we see.
Yes. Right.
Tomorrow is the anniversary of the death and the murder of George Floyd in Minnesota. And yet racism, injustice, unemployment, food insecurity, and bigotry and prejudice continue to reign in this country. Let's get back to work, and let's kick the devil's butt. We're ready.
But while Flager is celebrating, some of his fellow clergy are miffed at Cardinal Supich's double standards and disregard for rules, even having to request anonymity for fear of repercussions. One, a priest for 40 years in Chicago, explained Cardinal John Cody in the early 70s established term limits for pastors in the Archdiocese to prevent them from establishing little kingdoms in perpetuity for themselves.
Your father's eyes are always on you!
Speaking of Flager, who turned 72 on Saturday, one Chicago priest lamented, Flager has made himself a kingdom and enthroned himself as king. Nothing different than what Napoleon did two centuries ago in France. Recalling an event from 3 years ago, he summarized, any doubts about Flager's suitability to work as a priest were jettisoned with his stunt of closing down the Dan Ryan Expressway in 2018.
We made them clear, we are coming to shut down the Dan Ryan. We are not settling for anything less.
That stunt cost the city of Chicago over $1 million.
I will share my thoughts and feelings more in depth on Sunday, June 6th, when I walk out to celebrate service at the 10 a.m. liturgy.
While Flager shares his in-depth thoughts and feelings on the weekend of Corpus Christi, Catholics worldwide will be joining in Eucharistic adoration led by Budapest's Cardinal Archbishop Peter Erdő. William Mahoney, Church Militant, The Download, Detroit.
Flager's return to active ministry stands in stark contrast with other suspended priests like Father Paul Kalchek, who has no parish to return to for refusing to capitulate to Supich's pro-homosexual advocacy. So, yeah, Flager is not... He's not unknown to us. He first kind of came onto our radar when Obama was running for president. As we saw in William's report there, that Father Flager does sort of ape a particular style of preaching, which is really not consistent with, you know, Catholic preaching. And doesn't seem, I mean, let's put a delicate point in it, not consistent with his ethnicity. I mean, he's actually kind of wearing this sort of thing as a man. Where is the complaints about cultural appropriation about him? Answer, they're not there because he was radically supporting Barack Obama, and he's been radically supporting these leftist causes.
Yeah, I actually stumbled upon it was a YouTube video about, I think it was about like a Little League cheating scandal, mm-hmm. and had comments from Father Flager weighing in on this issue and saying, yeah, this team wouldn't be accused of cheating if it was a white team. In other words, implying that the cheating allegations were racially motivated, involving this yeah. this championship-winning Little League team during the Obama years. And yeah, I think it isn't worthwhile to note that, you know, as we said leading out of that video report, that priests, you know, there are other priests who are suspended, mm-hmm. driven out of town, things like that, never brought back, never reinstated. But a priest who's known for this left-wing activism, shutting down a freeway, weighing in on all kinds of political issues and racially related things, that he is restored to ministry after he's been cleared.
Yeah.
In the Father Kalchek case, he wasn't like really accused of anything that would know, merit suspension from ministry, being kicked out of the parish, driven out of town. It was that he, there are parishioners who burned a gay flag that had, I believe it's the same flag that had...
Yes.
In the sanctuary with a priest who was pro-gay, gay himself, etc.
Yeah, we've covered that story. And I think it's important to note that obviously Father Flager was cleared. I haven't been following the case closely, but I'm inclined to say that I believe that Father Flager didn't do anything like this. There was only a single accusation. Normally there are multiple accusations are made, you know, this is serial predation. I think that it probably was very much a question of just somebody trying to cash in with Father Flager there. So it's a completely unsubstantiated, unfair allegation. Father Flager is cleared. Behold justice. This is excellent. Here locally in Detroit, of course, unsubstantiated allegation with zero evidence, actually evidence that the evidence was made up and just doctored out of whole cloth. Here was brought against Father Perrone. Father Perrone was suspended, has been, the Rome has said there is no case to answer here. And now Father Perrone, of course, is still suspended at this point, and Father Flager's come back here. Father Kalchick was actually cleared by Rome. Supic was slapped down by the court in Rome and said, you're wrong, you can't do this. There's nothing happened there. So again, yeah, again, this horrible double standard. I'm very glad that justice has been done with regard to this sex abuse case or claim. I think that's very good. But certainly, no justice has been done for the church with what's been done for Flager.